So with this, we're formalizing our commitment to ESG principles. Investment into ESG early on itself helps you attract a greater class of investors. The fundamental role that VCRC plays is in terms of commercialization.
There's a lot of talk on environment these days. That's also because the United Nations Climate Change Conference is happening in Glasgow as we speak. It's also known as COP26. The other buzzword is ESG, environment, social and governance. And I have Mr. Siddharth Pai with me. He's the founder, partner and CFO of 314 Capital. You must be wondering why Smart Sustain is speaking to Siddharth. Siddharth is made the ESG officer for his own venture. Siddharth, this new role, what exactly mean to you in terms of your venture?
So ESG is something that's been part of our investing lens for a very long period of time. In fact, the recent induction we have, we're the first VC firm to become part of the UNPRI, the United Nations Principles of Responsible Investing. We're also the first VC fund in India to actually have the ESG officer role actually formally articulated. So with this, we're formalizing our commitment to ESG principles as part of our investing lens itself, and also to ensure that the role of capital actually becomes more productive, not just in terms of creating economic gains, but also in terms of creating social good as well as environmental good itself. Because the three components of ESG should actually underpin any investment that needs to happen in order for capital to actually create the change that the world so desperately needs as of now.
Thoughtful insights, Siddharth, and sustainability brings a cost tag on it. An entrepreneur has to balance between sustainability and economics. What is your message to entrepreneurs and corporates that sustainability in the long run brings economic incentives?
So in terms, I can actually answer that in terms of accounting. In terms of accounting, an expense is anything that is incurred during a short span of time and doesn't have any benefit going forward. Whereas an investment is an expense that actually gives you economic gains or gives you gains over a longer period of time. So an investment into ESG isn't necessarily an expense. There is a cost factor that's attributed to it as of now. But ESG always scales with the scale of the enterprise. So if you're a small enterprise, it doesn't mean that you need to become carbon neutral from day one. You need to articulate a plan to actually get into those particular paths. And with regard to social good and governance, these don't have any costs associated with it. This entails having a higher standard of principles that everyone actually needs to adhere to. And the investment into ESG early on itself helps you attract a greater class of investors, helps you attract a larger amount of capital, and also creates a greater good for the company in terms of your bottom line as well as the perception that it has. The brand equity that people are going to command in the market right now will always be a function of the ESG parameters that come in. And this is the way investors across the world are also looking. And the earlier a company can start articulating and practicing this, the better advantage it has compared to any of its peers in the market as well.
Your venture 314 Capital has been funding many startups, including the deep tech and fintech and even media too. There are a lot of sustainable startups from energy, water management and waste management. Do you have any plans to fund any of these sustainable ventures?
In fact, we've actually invested in a company called Exponent, which actually increases fast charging and also creates an entire protocol that's also more adaptable across various other fast charging standards and allows even retrofitted vehicles to actually become EVs itself. So these are the kind of ideas we're already investing into. And with regard to climate tech, any of these other pieces, see, the fundamental role that VCRC plays is in terms of commercialization. Whereas in India, a large amount of work has to go into the R&D itself. And R&D cannot be the mainstay of private equity or venture capital investors. R&D always comes from common sources, comes from philanthropic foundations, comes from family office, and comes from the like. We do have eyes on a few of these companies coming out from ISC and IITs as well. And we're actually keeping a very close tab on them. So the moment they become VC ready, and it becomes for us to actually add to their entire runway and to actually help them commercialize and become and scale, those are the companies we'll invest into. We've been looking for these companies for quite some time, and we do have companies such as Yulu, companies such as Exponent and others who've already come on board. And slowly over time, the pipeline will actually increase.
Thanks, Siddharth, for speaking to Smart Sustain. I wish you all the best for your new role. Smart Sustain is a dedicated media house which brings in views and news on sustainability practices and sustainability ventures. Thanks for watching.